Okay, so I already got his number and now I need to make sure that he texts me. So next time he posts on Instagram, I'm gonna post like this and then afterwards. All right, this is gonna work. I'm gonna try, gonna try, gonna try. Work till I die, till I die, till I die. I'm gonna fail and get up, cause I'm not giving up on my dream. Hey beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. I'm Kopano and this is How I Do Things, the show where you send me a question and I'll let you know how I do things. Now you can use it as entertainment or take it as advice. Use it, don't use it, do what you will with it. I'm just letting you know what I would do if I was in your shoes. Now today I have been in your shoes, darling. I have walked this path before. So let me tell you about the bait and switch. Let me tell you how to really shoot your shot in a way. It's kind of sneaky. He'll never see it coming. And in a funny way, you are the one going after him, but there's this point where things switch and he's going after you. Aha, honey girl, if you have a crush and you want your crush to chase you, but you kind of want to shoot your shot, I'm going to give you 8 steps. This works for you to go after the man you want, but then at some point, switch the game. So he comes after you. All right, so if you have any questions that you want to send to me for our next videos, head over to @KopanoShimange and look for this picture right here. It's in my Insta story highlights. All you have to do is go to the little lavender circle that says How I Do Things, click and you'll see this picture. Reply with whatever question you want to ask about money, about being a woman, about girl talk, whatever it is that is on your mind and you're wondering, what would you do if you're in the situation? Send it through and I'll do a video all about it. Listen, this is an 8-step process. You cannot skip a single step. I'm gonna get into it one at a time. Follow this. I'm telling you it's gonna work. Let's get into it. But hold up. If you have not subscribed to my channel, head over to the little red word that says subscribe. Click on it because it's completely free. But you get subscribed to this daily YouTube show that gives you all the tea on whatever questions that you have for me. So subscribe and join the gorgeous gang. Okay, so there's this guy you like. All right, either through social media or you know him in person or he's a colleague at work or somebody that you're seeing advice to, whatever it is, this works, okay? And it's an 8-step process that you have to follow. So you spot this guy and you like him. So you want to kind of go after him, but you also want to give him the sense that you know what, he knows how to seal the deal and he got you, right? So I'm gonna show you how to shoot your shot in a way that a man will never see it coming. All right, so number one is you need to make sure this guy's actually an eligible bachelor. Like this guy, he's disqualified if he's in a relationship. We're not trying to steal somebody from somebody else. We're not trying to take somebody else's man. This is not the show for that. Step number two is all about getting on his radar. Okay, so if this is your flame, the man you want, basically sometimes we are all the way out here, not even on the man's radar. And what we're trying to do is we're trying to edge into the shot, right? And some, hey, hi, what to do? And get into the picture for this guy. It's about these levels, right? And you just basically want to get onto the radar. So if there was a screen in his periphery, he can see certain girls. And if you are at a level where you are outside of that periphery, that guy doesn't know you exist, then you need to follow the rest of the steps to get onto his radar. Getting onto his radar is all about, at the very least, he needs to know who you are and that you are an option. You need to be out there. So if he's going like beep, 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 and he's searching for girls, you need to be in that pool there. Right? So if he doesn't know who you are, you need to find a way to connect with this guy. If it is in person, you want to bait him, right? You want to be in close proximity physically. So if you're lucky enough at work, you guys have an eating area, try and sit close to where he's sitting. If you are at a work situation, try and be around him in one way or another. If you see this guy at the supermarket all the time, you live in the same area and you guys are always at the same supermarket, try your very best to be the person behind him in the line and spark a situation, a conversation about the situation that you guys are in being at the line. And you're going to keep doing this until he starts to notice you, okay? So getting onto his radar is about being an option for him, letting him know that, hey, this is who I am and I am around here. I am somebody you know. Now you know me. So if you walk past me in public, you're gonna say hi because you know who I am. So that's what you want to do. Now, if you're on social media, you don't wanna become a stalker. We're not stalking. We're not gonna like all of the pictures. We're not doing that. We are going to comment on the ones we genuinely have something witty or interesting to say, okay? So that's how you get onto this person's radar. If you can, on the Insta stories, reply to something, always try and find a way to have some sort of wit and slight sarcasm. Just a little, not a lot. You don't want to bring him down, but you do want to enter with a bit of humor. When you start to do this and you do it often enough, that's when you start to get onto a person's radar. Okay, so now you're on his radar, right? Now you need to go from being on his radar to being somebody he wants to chat to. There's levels to this game. You know, there's the outer circle of people that you know of, and then there's an inner circle of people that you actually chat to, okay? So how this is going to happen is you're going to try and look for a reason to talk to this person on a regular basis. So that when you are around this person, they're not quiet when you're around them, they actually want to chat to you. So you want to try and connect on something. This is where you now start looking for things and topics where you guys have easy conversation. If it is sports, that is good. If it is something around the workplace, that's fine. Basically, you just need an excuse to talk to this guy, okay? If it is social media and you see that he has a specific interest, and every now and again he speaks about that interest, so you find out, okay, this guy is an accountant, but he likes to go to the gym, right? So you are going to then start to talk to him about these gym things. This doesn't mean you have to change yourself and all of a sudden you're a sports fanatic or a fitness bunny when you're not. It just means that it's a topic that you guys can chat about often. So if he goes to the gym and you're just like, you know what, you're motivating me so much to go to the gym, that's a topic for you to talk about. Then he goes to the next place and he's, you know, using a certain machine, or he posts a picture of himself inside a certain studio. You can just say to him, you know what, that studio looks really cool. Maybe instead of doing equipment stuff, I might just start doing studio workouts. You see, you keep going, my love. Find an excuse to chat to this person, because what you want to do here is you want to go from being somebody he knows of to somebody he chats to. That is now when you are graduating from being on the radar to moving levels up. You want to establish a special connection. What do I mean by this? You're either going to have an inside joke that runs between the two of you. This, you need to be here. You need to always be looking out for something that happens that the two of you have witnessed, or something that you can share with him that is a joke that runs in between the two of you, okay? So you're always gonna be looking for something that you guys can connect on. Connecting with a man on something that is funny is a really good thing to do. Having an inside joke that's running between the two of you, gold, darling. When you know that it's just between me and him, this joke that we have. So you guys are in the supermarket, this guy that you're constantly seeing at Woolies, and every time you go to Woolies, this guy's there, majority of the time. You're going to try and be behind him in the line, or when he goes and he buys milk, you're also gonna make sure that you're there at the same time and be like, hey, what's up? I'm seeing you here again. Wow, one. So once you have established this thing that you guys chat about, right? So you've been seeing him at the supermarket, you get onto his radar by buying milk at the same time he's buying milk. Then every time you guys are at the supermarket, you try and be behind him in the line, or, you know, be in front of him at the line. That's called baiting. And when you are there, you have a secret little, you have a conversation. You need to look out for anything that you can have a special connection or a special conversation about. It's also nice if you can find something to lightly tease him about. Let's say the accountant guy who goes to the gym, and you notice that you're just like, wow, you must really focus on your calf muscles. Those are some really interesting calf muscles. And then you put a wink. Remember, if you're teasing someone on social media via text, use emojis so that the person knows what feelings you have or what type of mood or vibe you're in when you say something. If you can find someone to have like a light tease or a light joke with the person, find it. And that's a nice thing, that he's going to associate you with a funny and nice moment that makes him feel good. The thing is, this is inception, okay? Because once you do this, even when you're not around, he may just think of that joke and think of you. What? We're inside, we are within. Once you get to this level, you have something unique that differentiates you from all the other girls. You have a special language. You have a unique thing. So if you find that you guys are both from the Eastern Cape, or you know, from the same province, and you guys know a certain thing together, mention something funny that is between the two of you. This works. This is how you establish a unique bond with this guy. We are now infiltrating the system. Let's move on. Now we're getting into it. Number five, this is now when you want to try and infiltrate and get a bit personal and start having more personal conversations. Because once you've established the secret code language and things like that, once you're done laughing about that, then you can start to ask him more questions about, yo, okay, cool. So you're an accountant. Where do you work? Or, okay, cool. I see that your surname is this. Are you from, you know, this province by any chance? You want to try and get more personal information about this person, because that's basically a line. The line that separates a person from an acquaintance that I just know, and yes, we share a funny joke, but you're still this side of the line. Once you start to get personal, that's when you get into more of the friendship, potential girlfriend type of thing, okay? So it's potential, it's friend with the potential of being girlfriend. So you want to cross that line by starting to get a little personal with this guy. If you guys have been having this running joke on social media, or there's something that you like to tease him about every now and again, you can start to get personal with him in the chats and then start to move the conversation over to WhatsApp, okay? If you're brave enough to say, yo, let's chat on WhatsApp. I don't always see my messages on Instagram, especially if you take time to respond to him and be like, oh, you know what? I actually didn't see this message. Sorry about that. Do you want to chat on Instagram instead, on WhatsApp instead? That's a way for you to move the conversation so you can get his number. So when you start to chat on a more personal basis, where now you're talking outside of work, or you guys are talking outside of, you know, at the supermarket where you guys are meeting, that's when now the line is crossed. And once you cross that line, you want to start dropping the flirts, okay? Each of these levels takes a little bit of time. Once you've gotten onto his radar, give it about a week, move on to, you know, getting a level up on him, having a unique connection with him. Then afterwards, give it about a week of that. The next week after that, you want to start, you know, establishing a secret joke that you have with him. Once you guys have got that running joke going, the week after that, then you get a little bit personal, you know, ask if he's got any siblings, you know, all of that stuff. Personal questions that are related to the conversation. You don't want to just be there like, hey, have you got any sisters? What about your mom? How about your dad? How are things going with this? Where are you born? Where did you go to school? Where did you go to high school? And then college? And then what were your majors? Huh? Back up, girl. Back up. Slowly, we're moving in. Remember, we are infiltrating the system slowly but surely. The flame is over here. We are all the way over here. And we want to try an inch, an inch, an inch, an inch closer to the flame. Okay? So don't go too fast, or else you're going to run and bump your head and the whole situation is just ruined. Step number six is, now that we know that, okay, fine, I'm having chats with this guy. We are chatting on a regular-ish basis. Every time I see him, we chat. So you want to start dropping those flirts, which means eye contact, babes. Eye contact, okay? You want to, every now and again, make a cute little joke about how he looks and he's looking good today, how he smells, you know, compliments. Flirtation, it works, honey. You want to also smell good yourself, you know. You might, even when you're laughing, just laugh and just touch his hand a little. Flirtation, start to flirt with the guy, because now we've gone over the line of being personal with him, but now because of the flirtation, we're starting to itch closer to that. Is there a vibe here? Now we move on to number seven, which is getting the opportunity to be alone with this person, okay? I'll tell you that what happened with, you know, my man, ne? I met him in a work situation and I did these moves. I didn't even know I was doing them. Now I look back, I'm just like, oh damn, this is what I did. And we started to chat in a work capacity. Then we had a running inside joke. I can't even remember what it was, but it was funny and it was between the two of us. And then we started to get a bit more personal, started to find out a little bit about his family. He started finding out a little bit about my personal life, specifically around my dating situation. Then we started to chat a little bit about those things that we were chatting about before. Then when I got to step number seven, I was the one who initiated it, right? I asked him, yo, I'm going to the zoo and I'm going alone. Do you want to come with me? He said yes. And this primed me for the next step. So you want an opportunity alone. So Mr. Supermarket Guy, you may find that you guys have been chatting in the line and you've gotten to the point where now you guys are walking out with your plastics or with your paper bags filled with food in them, and you guys are just chatting for a long time by the door. When you start to have conversations with this guy and you get a little bit more personal and you start to have conversations outside of, you know, the supermarket or the workplace, or you're chatting, this is an opportunity for you guys to be alone or to see each other, okay? When you move onto this, be the one who is initiating, in that, you know, I was gonna go to this place anyway. Do you wanna come with? So supermarket guy is like, oh, you know, I was actually gonna just go grab a bite by myself. Do you wanna join? Things like that. So you wanna look like you've got a life, ne? And you are squeezing him in. But it's an opportunity for you guys to finally connect alone, okay? I was thinking of going to go see this movie, but I can't find anybody to go with. Do you wanna go with me? Casual, right? But when you meet, this is now where you are starting to shoot your shot a little bit more, right? Now you're passing the ball over to him, you're flirting with him, and you're letting him know that, yo, I'm actually into you, right? And this, once you get alone with the guy, you guys are having good conversation and you've gotten to the stage. We move on to number 8, my darling. And that is the bait and switch, okay? This is how it works. So you guys are alone, and so far, you've been the one to initiate the conversations. You've been the one to initiate, you know, the jokes that you guys have been having. You've been the one to initiate you guys being alone. This is where the switch happens. Sometimes it may happen on the first time that you guys are alone together or out together, or it may happen on the third time. But the point is, when you guys are out, continue to flirt and continue to give him opportunity to take the lead. And this is where the switch happens. Because honestly, I think girls should shoot their shot, but I like a man to chase me too. And this is where it switches from you chasing him to him chasing you. Because you've let him know that, yo, if you shoot your shot with me, I'ma let you land it. That's it, that I like you. You know that I like you because I've flirted with you, I'm out with you, I really like chatting with you. So you may need to give him the opportunity to reciprocate, okay? It may take a couple of times. You guys may go out 4 or 5 times, but initiate the first time. And once it's done, if he has not taken, you know, the lead after the first time when you guys go out together with friends or just the two of you casually, remember, it's not a date, it's casual, then put the ball in his court by saying, yo, I really enjoyed hanging out with you today, wouldn't mind doing it again, you let me know, right? So you put the ball in his court. So you want to constantly try and put the ball in his court. You got him to the tennis court by conversation and jokes and all of those things. Now you pass the ball over to him and say, I like hanging out with you. I've been flirting with you. Now it's your turn to take the lead. Bait and switch, honey. It works. Ha! It works. Let me know if you guys are going to try this. That is my 8-step process. Levels to the game. I hope that you guys enjoyed this one because I really did. This was a masterclass. This was a masterclass. Give it a big thumbs up if you like it. Share it with one of your friends who's just like, I like this girl, I don't know what to do. Share it with one of your girls who's just like, yo, this guy's driving me nuts, I don't know what to do. Share it. Until next time, beautiful people, I'm Kopano Shimange, and this was how I do things. Until later days, bye. How loud can I get when I'm excited? Love this video. Hope that you guys enjoyed it as well. But until next time, beautiful people, thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. If you have not subscribed yet, here's my face here. Click on it and you will get full access to my channel. You will be able to see when I upload, because I upload every single day at 7:30. And if you have not gone over to my website to download my book, The 7 Hacks to Building and Boosting Your Confidence, then here it is, www.kopanoshimange.com. Until next time, beautiful people, enjoy this one. Mwah. Bye.